This week on Maker Update, making the world's fastest drone, a convenient cage for your soul, a deluxe beetle, and the return of the Eggbot. Hey everyone, I'm Donald Bell, and this is Maker Update, our weekly show covering the coolest projects and tips from makers like you. I hope you're doing well. Happy Halloween. Let's get started with the project of the week. What does it take to make the world's fastest quadcopter drone? That's a question being asked by the father-son team of Mike and Luke Bell, no relation to me. These two have set the world speed record twice. First with a 400 kilometer an hour record in 2023 and then 480 in 2024, which is around 300 miles per hour. But the record was quickly beaten in the US and then taken further by a competitor in Switzerland. To get back on top, the record they have to beat is an astounding 558 kilometers an hour or 346 miles per hour. Both Mike and Luke have their own separate videos about the design and engineering process that led them to break this record. I'll include links to both down in the description. And I have to admit, I'm not much of a drone guy, but I was gripped by both of these 15-minute plus videos because when you're tackling an extreme engineering challenge like this, whether it's Formula One or a Martian rover design, I'm hooked. It also helps that they're both great storytellers, and there's a lot of story to tell here. For the electronics, Luke had to create a fully custom 3D printed water cooling system to keep the electronic speed controllers from bursting into flames. Because not only was an air-cooled design not getting the job done, but it was creating drag in a scenario where speed is paramount. But I think the craziest fact about the electronics in this system is how extremely power hungry the whole thing is in order to achieve record-breaking speed. At peak power, this drone uses between 15 to 16 kilowatts of power. That's the equivalent of three homes running all their appliances and lights at once. So it's no surprise that the battery makes up the bulk of the design. And even with this relatively giant battery, at full throttle, the battery drains in just 23 seconds. And that's just one aspect of the hurdles this two-man team had to overcome, from aerodynamics to material selection, weight distribution to radio stability. It's an enthralling, inspiring achievement with a feel-good father-son story running through it. Highly recommended. More projects. In honor of Halloween, check out this ESP32-based Soul Cage by Vishal Soni, aka Electro Donut. Guide on Instructables includes the list of materials, the code, and the 3D Tinkercad design that holds it all together. The device itself is pretty straightforward. There's a slide switch to turn it on and off, and a button to switch between the two included animations. The only tricky bit here are the relatively minor modifications recommended for the circuit board. To help with power management, there are some traces you'll want to cut and wire to the power switch. Not an easy task for a beginner. But it's nothing compared to the insane, beetle-inspired pendant dreamed up by Cats Creates and Mr. Volt. For a few days, they were given an opportunity to play around with all the tools and methods available at Forum Labs HQ. They took this chance to explore casting techniques for 3D printed objects, allowing the possibility of creating a sterling silver, jewelry grade version of the design. The project journey here is full of twists and turns, material challenges, mechanical challenges, challenges wiring up all the addressable LEDs that fit inside. But for an end result that looks like nothing I've ever seen before, I'd say it was worth the effort. Now for some tips and tools. Before Evil Mad Scientist Laboratories was acquired by Bantam Tools in 2024, one of the oddest, most specific products they made was the Eggbot. It was a plotter designed to draw on spherical objects like an Easter egg. Well, the Eggbot lives on. There's now a Bantam Tools version available, marketed as a holiday ornament edition. I think if you're already someone who's a little plotter obsessed, this could be a great way to channel that energy into some unique custom holiday ornaments for your family and friends. personally, I'm just happy to know that we live in a world where the Eggbot endures. Fun fact, an early version of the Eggbot was first shown at the original Maker Faire in 2006. On the Tested YouTube channel, Megan Gardner and Taylor Pope, aka Fernside Dragons, visit Adam Savage and proceed to spend 48 minutes explaining all the secret knowledge of creating your own inflatable costumes. From choosing the right material, creating sewing patterns, getting details to fill out the way you want, types of fans to push air in, and design strategies to keep air from getting out, it's an incredible resource for anyone thinking of making their own inflatables. As many of you know, Tinkercad is a great free tool for creating 3D printable designs. I'm a big fan, and they've recently added some exciting new features that make it an even more capable tool. The latest addition is a revolve tool that allows you to quickly sketch out a profile and revolve it 360 degrees. Think of it like a lathe or a pottery wheel. It's perfect for creating rounded objects with complex curves, like a chess piece or a vase. Their new sketch capability also adds editable vector-based shape creation, similar to drawing in Illustrator, where you can create subtle curves, define the width of your stroke, and make all kinds of surprisingly detailed adjustments. I'm excited to give it a whirl. And on Hackaday, Thomas Ferrer offers a great tip on how to use inexpensive nail art tools to transfer embossed 3D printed designs onto enclosures and other projects. The cool tool here is this soft silicone stamp transfer that is made to pick up a stenciled nail polish design and apply it to any surface, even a rounded and uneven surface like a human nail. It looks like a super useful technique and inexpensive to get started with. For this week's DigiKey Spotlight, we've got an unboxing of the new Arduino Uno Q that you can see on DigiKey's Product Discovery channel, which is a separate channel from the one you're watching here. The Uno Q is an unprecedented new spin on the Uno line of boards that have been fundamental to the world of DIY electronics. In this 2-minute video, you'll get a useful glimpse at what the update is all about and some exciting new code demos that come included. Check it out. All right, and that does it for this week's show. Be sure to subscribe, leave a thumbs up, leave a comment. A big thanks to DigiKey for making this show possible, and thank you for watching. I'll see you soon.